Good afternoon, Megha. How are you doing?
Very well, Pankaj. How are you doing?
Everyone's doing fine. We're all at home, wearing formals at home. You're looking very good, as always.
Thank you.
You know why we have a grey background? The uncertainty attached with COVID. So everything is grey, nothing is black and white, right? At this point in time.
Which is like more pink because there is hope.
There's a lot of hope. So I'm going to spend about 15 minutes with you on this. Out of 15 minutes, we'll spend about 7-8 minutes on COVID diaries and the impact that it's had on the industry. More importantly, particularly with you, I want to spend 5 to 7 minutes on immunity building, right? What it takes to not age, right? So you heard that all the time. In fact, I was chatting up with Zubin day before and yeah. He said hi to you.
Hey, hi to him back whenever you speak to him next then.
Yeah, so I'm sure he's going to be watching this. On Zoom, watching you right now. But so coming back to the first part of COVID diaries, everyone that I've spoken to over the last 1 week has been saying that Corona has had a huge impact, either on health, on people directly, or indirectly on our lives in terms of how we run the business. How are things impacting Discovery, Southeast Asia that you had now?
South Asia first. Well, I think you're right, Pankaj. First of all, it has been impacted for every industry, not just ours, across the spectrum. But if I was to say one thing, you know, there's this movie, one of my favorite movies called Band Baja Barat. And I don't know whether you've seen that, but there's this dialogue in that where she says, you know, recession ho ya inflation, shaadiyan to hoti rahengi, right? So in the same tone, in the same spirit, you know, inflation ho ya recession, content to dekhte rahenge ro. People will want to watch content, you know, and that is what I think our industry has proven, that we want, the content consumption has grown humongously on across platforms, across genres, especially for our genre. In fact, Discovery has shown 40%, 46%, if I'm not mistaken, growth in impressions, including the kids genre. I think the three genres which have grown in their performances, infotainment, movies, and kids, and we are there, two out of those three. So there's been a positive impact as well, besides the fact that, of course, the business is been hugely impacted, and that is true to everyone, I reckon.
I think I was coming more on the side on advertising. So I was talking to Rajiv Dubey, Avinash Pandey, your peers across different channels. They're all saying that advertising revenue could be safely assumed for Q1 at almost a 50% hit. Free-to-air channels would hugely depend on that. Pay channels like Discovery would have almost 60% coming out from advertising. So if you lose 50% of that, that brings tough times, right? So how are you coping up with that one? And two, programming, original programming goes is now on a halt.
Yeah. So two things you've asked, advertising and content. So let me answer the advertising part first. Absolutely. And we're not the only ones. I think across industry, everyone is facing the advertising revenue impact. Not only broadcasters, but advertising agencies are facing the impact of revenue as well. But it is what it is. We have to deal with it. We have to find smarter ways to, work the business around it. I think what's going to happen really, Pankaj, is that this will also get all the businesses to rethink and reimagine, you know, and they, this is probably many organizations are going to do a reset button in how to run a business and how to make ready for such kind of event calamities if they were to strike any one of us. God forbid it never happens again. But so I think there is a lot of introspection which is taking place and has to from a future sustainability point of view. But as of right now, here and now, clearly it's been a huge impact. And if they're saying less than more than 50%, I would completely agree. Yeah. With reference to content, I think we are relatively better placed. And the reason I say that is because we are not impacted by the daily production requirement of GC, who need to produce content, you know, every day content needs to be created to keep the freshness. We have a lot of content, and which has been already been produced for months in advance, because that's how our genre functions, and because of the depth of library discovery has globally, there's a lot of content we've been able to continue to put out there. In fact, we're premiering a lot of content as well. In fact, Discovery Network probably is one of the few across who are premiering content even in this time, and that is proven to the fact that the content consumption has grown, and our channel shares have grown. So in my view, our genre has really been not so dramatically affected in terms of from a production point of view, but from a content consumption, in fact, it's only helped us.
So sorry to cut you. Avinash from Singapore says hi to you. Avi Himmat Singhani, come on.
Hi,
Manish Rao, well said, rethink and reimagine, right? So adding on to what you are saying, I think the times, there is a little bit of apprehension here. So I'll share some statistics with you. Flu pandemics in the past, 1968 took about 1 million people away. 1918, again a flu pandemic, went on to almost 20 to 50 million. The numbers are a little scary. I don't think 2nd of May would be beginning back to normal, right? So that's going to stay for a while. Offices, you think work from home is going to be a little bit more as we move along once things normalize as well?
I think so. I think this time has taught us that, you know, we can survive from working from home. All of us in the media industry have definitely proven. I mean, sitting at home, you still are seeing content on the channels. You're seeing, you know, OTT platform. We launched Discovery Plus in this environment and this in these.
I think what an appropriate time to get into OTT at this point in time. Is it seeing a good traction? A lot of people downloading Discovery Plus?
Oh, yes. It's got a fantastic feedback. We've got some great...
Let me also take the time to blow my own trumpet. We launched Chrome OTT measurement at the same point in time, right?
Fantastic.
Two platforms measuring OTT in, consumption across with 70 respondents at this point in time. So I think this is a good time for OTT, right? So
it's definitely a good time for OTT. It's a good time for content, frankly. You know, people are wanting to watch a lot of content. So that's happening. So Discovery Plus has done extremely well. We've got some great traction, a lot of great feedback, great app ratings. And the fact that, you know, we are the only differentiated offering in the milieu of OTT presence in our country is a refreshing aspect, which is what people have appreciated. So it's good for a lot of content consumption point of view. TV viewership is at high, you know, content consumption is at high. However, we are unable to monetize it, and that is a huge challenge.
I think that's going to take quarter one is going to be a rough one, because product offtake is hugely limited. I was reading about Oyo today. They're going through a tough time, hotel industry, travel industry. So that's going to take a little bit of time to recover. And as they recover is when the money comes back to television.
In fact, that is the thing. Such industries, airlines, service industry, hospitality, restaurant business, all of them have a far bigger impact than probably media industry at the moment. So I think
we're dependent on all of them put together, not only on one of them. But this could be a good time for brands to use this for brand building, right? Because the clutter is less, right? Product offtake could be low, but
absolutely. Please tell all the advertisers that. Yeah.
He gave me an analogy saying when the stock markets are down, it's cheaper to buy shares, but you don't have the money to buy them, right? But there are advertisers, yeah. I suppose.
I think this is the absolute right time to build your brand resilience, actually, in on platforms. And you know, broadcasters will give you a damn good deal as well if that is going to be of any, you know, interest for clients. But I think that's really where hope some of the brands are thinking on those lines, because clearly from a pure product play advertising, there is a huge hit which has taken place across.
Yeah, absolutely. I think this is the right time to get a little more bullish since the markets are. So I think it's a good time. Brands need to get a little more aggressive. People who have some investments. Facebook made an investment of almost what, some 10 billion with Jio, with $5 billion at Jio. So there is money in the market, and I think this is a good time to invest. I don't think you can hear me. Can you hear me?
I can now.
Okay, lovely. So I think let's hope for the times to move back to normal for all channels, all brands. Discovery has been there in the business for a long, long time. I'm sure things will shape up soon for all.
Yeah. I mean, in fact, like I was talking about, premieres and performances, but you know, the Rajni episode we aired during these times was we hit the ball out of the park after the PM Modi episode. This was a huge the number two.
I think biggest. That was a master. That was a brilliant pull off, Rajni. I saw that episode.
Yeah.
Rajnikant, you made good monies on the back of those two episodes.
Yes, we did. We did. Now we have more stuff planned, and we want the advertisers to support it as well, because we have some great lineup of content. The premiers, actually, because we are our partners on the ground, and all the LCOs who have been really supportive in continuing our service across during these times. So that's been a huge help for us. For
your distribution
sure.
is very strong. I can vouch for that. Your distribution and availability is very strong, right? So I think during the time
that's a great endorsement.
Thank you. So we'll get to the more important part when it comes to you in particular, Megha. Right, and the reason why I brought in Zubin, because we all unanimously agree that there are some things that don't age, some people who don't age, right? And I bring that to immunity. Everyone is talking about immunity. COVID has come. There are more viruses and problems that are going to come to humanity. The one thing that we all need is to build our immunity and make ourselves strong. I've known you for 2 decades. We all go through ups and downs, but someone who does it gracefully, with no stress, right? How do you manage? You want to send in a message to everyone on immunity, on what it is, what it takes to just be strong throughout.
Thanks, Pankaj, for those lovely words, and appreciate that. But I think one of the things I realized about a decade ago was the fact that we've got to look inwards more first before we look outwards. And I think that came through my after I started following Sadhguru, and I'm I'm very deeply involved with the meditation tools which Sadhguru has provided me and us and whoever will follow him. So I have really seen a huge benefit ever since I started following that, not only in terms of my physicality of being strong, but even mentally. And I think in our world, when we have to deal with so many things which are not in your control, which is what Sadhguru says, like, what's not in your control, don't focus on that. What you can control is yourself.
Sorry to cut you, but it is so uncertain. The world is so dynamic. Whoever knew that the entire month of April, 1/3 of the globe would spend indoors?
Exactly. Like, who would know? Who would have ever thought of these things, right? And to the points which you mentioned earlier, when the pandemics have been there and, so many people have died in the past. And that was at a time when travel wasn't there as much. So imagine the potential of something like this when you are able to travel so much and maybe have the potential to transfer this even more. It becomes that much more social responsibility for you as an individual to be more conscious. And I think I have personally really benefited in managing my work-life balance through the spirituality path I have chosen to walk on. And so maybe that's what is showing results as well. So yeah, I hugely propose for everybody to have some form of balance and spiritual balance in some form, whatever whoever you believe in, and whatever you find time for yourself to get yourself aligned, across from so you're mentally and physically, and you see how it really helps overall.
Absolutely. So I was chatting up with Swamiji, Subramanian Swami. He's 80 plus. He's got a glow on his face all the time. And when we spoke of spirituality, he tells me that spirituality is not above being who you are. Spirituality is normal, right? And if you are not spiritual, then there is something missing.
Yeah.
Right? So people need to relook at it that way.
Totally agree. Absolutely. Yeah. Extremely important to keep that balance because, life is too short. We've seen this now. It's just unpredictable. So at least find time for yourself to be able to keep that balance. And it doesn't have to be either or. You know, I don't understand people when they say, I don't have the time. I'm like,
absolutely.
Really? You don't have the time? It's like, how do you not have time? Why does it have to be either I am very spiritually aligned or I am very, on a machine running on a treadmill? Why can't we have both? Why does it have to be either or? Why can't it be and? So I'm a big believer of and I have, I'm a live example, to be honest. Yeah.
Absolutely. I couldn't agree more with that. I think life is a balance.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you. Your voice keeps cracking, but we heard all the important things that you had to say. I think it's all about striking. It's all about striking a balance in life. And life is really uncertain. Life is too short, right? How can you not have time for yourself? And spirituality is absolutely so important. It was great chatting up with you, Megha. It always is.
Thank you, right? Thanks for this opportunity. Lovely chatting with you. Hi to everyone else who was watching.
Yeah, and not everyone, you can't see the Facebook comments live on this one, but once you go back, you will find all the comments of all the people who are watching this. And once we edit this, we're going to put down the video, hopefully tonight, on YouTube, and we'll chat up with it, right? So lovely. Thank you, Megha. Do not age. You haven't aged in the last 20 years, and do not age ever, right? Good chatting up, and we shall meet.
Thank you. Take care. Stay safe. Bye, guys. Bye.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Megha. Thank you. Bye.